Are you worried every time you get sick and choose not to go to hospital to get medical attention because you don't have any funds or insurance to cover it? Well, change that notion now and get checked before it gets worse. As the Philippines' landmark bill called Universal Healthcare for All Filipinos is now a law. So let us define what is exactly a universal healthcare. Well, a universal healthcare is where all citizens of a particular territory or country can access the health services they need to either stay healthy or improve their health without suffering from financial hardship. It is a way of reducing poverty and increasing health security so that no one is left behind. What does it mean to Filipinos with the passage of Universal Healthcare Act of 2019? It means that every Filipino citizen is entitled to an affordable and quality health services while protecting them from enduring financial hardship as a result. Recently, social media went into a frenzy in connection to PhilHealth's memo regarding the increase in contribution of PhilHealth members. This, however, is stipulated in the Universal Healthcare Law, which has been enacted into law on February of 2019. In this video, we're going to break down major benefits of this law to us, Filipino citizens. First, every Filipino can access full spectrum of health services that includes a preventive care. A preventive care is any medical service that defends against health emergencies. It includes doctor visits such as annual physical exams, well woman appointments, and dental cleanings. Before, you can only avail of PhilHealth insurance once you get sick, but now, even if you're not sick, you can use this insurance to cover that. Promotive care. A promotive care is a process of enabling people to increase control over and to improve their health. It moves beyond a focus on individual behavior towards a wide range of social and environmental interventions. For example, promoting breastfeeding, promoting child and family nutrition, AIDS prevention and education, injury prevention, promoting physical activity, etc. Curative care. A curative care refers to healthcare practices that treat patients with the intent of curing them, not just reducing their pain or stress. An example is chemotherapy, which seeks to cure cancer patients. Rehabilitative or rehabilitation services. It is a healthcare service that helps you get back or improve skills and functioning for daily living that have been lost or impaired because you were sick, hurt, or disabled. Palliative care. It is a specialized medical care for people living with a serious illness. This type of care is focused on providing relief from the symptoms and stress of the illness. The goal is to improve quality of life for both the patient and the family. The healthcare system designed in the Universal Healthcare Law now includes outpatient care on top of the normal inpatient care provided by PhilHealth before. Filipino citizens' consultation, together with some prescribed medicines with their healthcare provider, is now covered under the new law. Second, membership are simplified into two classification categories. Direct and indirect contributors. Direct contributors are those who pay PhilHealth premiums, employed and bound by an employer-employee relationship, self-earning, professional practitioners, and migrant workers. Members qualify dependents and lifetime members are also included. In previous health system we have, these contributors can automatically reap the insurance benefits. The other is the indirect contributors, or those who are not considered as direct contributors, along with their qualified dependents, whose health premiums are subsidized by the government. In previous health system, these are not covered, but now they can also reap the benefits same as the direct contributors. Third, what are free and what are not? Only basic services accommodations will be covered by PhilHealth. As a patient, that means that if you're admitted in a hospital, you can expect this for free. Regular meals, a bed in a shared room with fan ventilation, and a shared toilet. What is not free is when one wants to stay in a hospital room, offering private accommodation, air conditioning, telephone, television, and meal choices, among others. As long as a patient avails of these basic accommodations, it will be covered by PhilHealth whether it's a public or in private hospital. The co-payment or a payment made by a beneficiary, especially for health services, in addition to that made by an insurer, will be regulated by the DOH. Every patient and his or her immediate family should know how much is being paid by PhilHealth on a particular procedure or treatment being availed. Then, they can prepare to pay such amount in excess paid by PhilHealth. However, for those indirect contributors who are availing of the services of public hospitals, PhilHealth has so-called no-balance billing, which guarantees that the patient will not pay a dime of the services availed. Fourth, the care starts at the community. The universal healthcare is designed to have every Filipino family in the community level shall have a family medicine doctor. This doctor shall be their attending doctor at the primary level of healthcare. Then, if a patient needs to access the next level of healthcare services, they will be referred to the appropriate healthcare provider by their family medicine doctor. While we are waiting for the full implementation of the Implementing Rules and Regulations, or IRR, made by PhilHealth and DOH, community-level doctors may not be realized until the complete rollout of the IRR due to the current COVID-19 pandemic. Fifth, where to get the funds? To fund this enormous undertaking, the Philippine government is embarking on different tax reforms since 2016. The SIN tax law, meant to help the funding of this 257 billion peso endeavor in just the first year of its implementation. That's according to the Health Secretary. Additionally, the government is sourcing 50% of the national government's share in Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, or PAGCOR, 40% of PCSO's charity fund, premium contributions of direct contributory members, and PhilHealth annual budget. Funding the health services of 109 million Filipinos and counting is a monumental task and needs a lot of coordination from various national and local government agencies. Sixth, functions of government agencies are well defined under the Universal Healthcare Law. According to the National Economic and Development Authority, or NEDA, the Philippine health system has been operating in a devolved setup. Noticed why barangay health centers are unequipped and incapable of delivering some basic health services? Yeah, it's because its budget is from the barangay, and we all know that barangay gets the last drop of budget from the national government. The universal healthcare will change that setup. Under the law, DOH will still be in charge of population-based services, which refers to programs for disease surveillance, health promotion campaigns, and mass immunization campaigns, while PhilHealth will be in charge of the individual-based health service that refers to services that can be accessed within a health facility. Health system will now be citywide and province-wide. Provinces and highly urbanized cities will now be in charge of overseeing health services in areas, as opposed to the current setup where municipalities are tasked with managing their own health centers. Let's take Cebu as an example. The provincial government of Cebu will now be in charge of all healthcare network of clinics and hospitals instead of each municipality overseeing it. And with highly urbanized city of Cebu City, Mandaue, and Lapu-Lapu, they are in charge of their own clinics or hospital in their barangays. Provincial and city health boards will be in charge of pooling and managing a special health fund to finance and improve health services for residents. PhilHealth's income will also be channeled to the special health fund. So in case you feel sick, do not let it worse. Get yourself checked by a medical professional. The universal healthcare will help you not to suffer a financial burden as a result of that. You will not be jumping from one agency to another, since all inpatient care is under one roof, and that's PhilHealth. In addition, malasakit centers are also in place for select hospitals across the country. It's an additional layer of protection to make sure that Juan de la Cruz will not go bankrupt. You can check out more information in regards to the Universal Healthcare Law and its IRR by visiting the Department of Health's website at www.doh.gov.ph. That's it for this week's video, guys. I hope you learned something out of our video today. Watch out for our next video next week. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Cheers!